Hey everybody, happy new October 20, and today we're gonna watch one video by Brad Williams. It is one more stand-up comedian, and we'll try to guess what he is saying, because I'm a Russian man who improves English and who brings value through my own experiences of this learning, and you can join to our channel by clicking like button and subscribing if you want. And we will go to this video right now. We will try to understand what he is saying, and maybe I will understand, maybe will not. We will guess right now. Yes, you can guess in the comment section below, by the way. Let's join to this. Brad Williams, Leprechaunian. Okay. He looks crazy, like this person, Jamie Lannister, or who? Someone from, you know, Game of Thrones. I didn't see this, but okay.
I know.
He's curious.
Let's be honest with ourselves for 1 second. Shit just got interesting, okay? Now it's a party. Now we're in Montreal, and now we're here when there's actually good weather. I've been here in the winter. Y'all can fuck off, all right? I don't like your winter. I do not like it. I'm from Southern California. I am not used to it. You guys get snow. I don't like it. I was in Edmonton over the winter where they got a storm. When I say a storm, I mean a foot and a half of snow in a day. In one day, foot and a half of snow. One day, and I'm on stage talking about it like, this sucks. And everyone's in the audience is like, it's Edmonton. That's what fucking happens here, dearie. And I hated it, and no one got it. They're like, it's no big deal. It's just a foot and a half of snow. I am 4 feet fucking tall, okay?
4 feet, how much is it in Russian thing? 4 feet. Feet in... It is 121, wow. It is so small. Small as 121. It is me when I was in eighth... No. When I was 8 years old, or maybe even 6. Wow, it's so small. Jesus, so small child, Leprechaunian. Okay.
It's a little different for me. Maybe you guys go out in a foot and a half of snow, you trip, you fall, your knee gets wet. It's winter time. If I trip
He speaks winner like he's from Cockney region, like Boa. Yes.
And fall in a foot and a half of snow, I die. You understand how that works? I was scared. I went to one of those sporting goods stores. I bought one of those soccer flags. I just duct taped that shit to my back and just started walking around. People were making fun of me. Brad, you look like a loser. Don't care. I'm gonna live. But I get it, though. I get why people are very excited when they see a little person. I understand. Because I'm not thinking about this all the time. I don't walk around all day in my head just, I'm midget. I don't do that. I know, if your life had DDR, you would have all 30 seconds back right there. Just.
What is DDR?
I know, if your life had DDR.
DVR, DDR. When I'm DDR first. DDR may refer to the DVR durable water repellent. It's a coating added to fabrics at the factory to make them water resistant. No. I don't understand what's again. One moment.
If your life had DVR, you would
DVR DVR mini. Digital video recorder. Maybe, okay. Maybe.
Of all 30 seconds back, right there. Just. I'm midget. I get
DVR,
it.
DVR, okay.
It. Here's the thing, though. I love being a little person because I bring so much happiness to people.
Exactly.
Like, you just see a dwarf and you're happy. It doesn't matter. We bring happiness to all sorts of circumstances. Dwarves are like human bacon, okay? We make everything better, no matter what the situation. The situation's boring, we make that better too. Yeah, boring things, grocery shopping. Nothing entertaining about grocery shopping. You guys do it, I do it. There's nothing fun about grocery shopping, but I buy one box of Lucky Charms. Holy shit!
Lucky Charms. I don't know what is it. Lucky Charms. like a charms. I did. Oh, Leprechaunian! Wow! Really? It is funny. It is funny, yes. Like this small dude buys Leprechaunian food like a charms. Interesting. Maybe need to review things from America. Yes. One more idea to video.
And if you're not laughing, you're not picturing this in your head right now. Could you imagine being in a grocery store, you look down an aisle, and I'm just walking down with my box of Lucky Charms. If you saw that, you'd be like, fuck it, I'm buying a lottery ticket. This is the greatest day of my life.
I'm gonna buy a lottery ticket. It's the greatest day of my life. Nice, nice words, really. Need to learn this expression.
With all the joy I bring to people's lives, it's amazing to me that certain fears and misunderstandings still exist. And I say that fears because there is that specific fear. It's something called achondrophobia. It's a fear of little people, okay? It exists, it's out there. Trust me, I've seen it, which is mind-boggling to me, because like, well, how the fuck could you be afraid of me? It's not like this shit is contagious, okay? I can't walk up to you, scratch your knee, and you go, I'm melting. Like, that doesn't happen. I've encountered it a few times in my life, but nothing could have prepared me for the time I met a celebrity who has this fear, achondrophobia. Don't worry, I'll tell you who it is, okay? John Stamos. Yes, 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 that.
One moment, need to Google this. John Stamos, American actor. John Philip Stamos is an American actor, producer, musician, comedian, and singer. He first gained recognition for his contract role as Blackie Parrish on the ABC television series General Hospital, for which he was nominated for the Daytime Emmy Award for Outstanding Supporting Actor in Drama Series. He was in Full House TV show, Fuller House, Grant Fathered, ER, and General Hospital. Okay, it is one dude, looks like this person from The Greatest Showman, from Lipton commercial. How to say it? Who is it? The Greatest Showman. One person, I forgot his name. Hugh Jackman, yes. Hugh Jackman, Mexicanish.
John Stamos has achondrophobia. I had no idea until I did a charity comedy show with Bob Saget. Bob Saget, his co-star from the show. Bob Saget shows up to this charity show with John Stamos and Dave Coulier. They are still all friends, which is awesome. And I'm just waiting in my dressing room. All of a sudden, Bob Saget bursts into my dressing room, just, Brad, you have to come meet John Stamos. And I'm like, well, yeah, I would love to meet John Stamos. I love the show Full House. He played Uncle Jesse, the character. You know, the band was called Jesse and the Rippers, right? And the catchphrase, have mercy. I would love to meet John Stamos. He goes, Brad, you don't get it. Stamos is terrified of little people. Well, then I know what I must do, Bob Saget. The plan goes into action. Saget runs into his dressing room. He starts distracting John Stamos. He turns his back to the door. When that happens, I know that's my cue. I run in, I see Stamos, I run right up to him, I grab his leg, I start humping.
Humping, is it twerking or what? Humping, it is specific movement like he does, yes?
John Stamos looks down, sees me, and I'm not gonna lie, John Stamos screams like a bitch, okay? He does, can you look down, and starts freaking out, and starts kicking his leg like this. He starts kicking his leg like this, trying to make me fly off like I'm a horny cocker spaniel or some shit.
But horny cocker spaniel.
I'm not flying off from that leg because I have little pug arms, and when I latch on, I fucking latch on. So now I'm on his leg. He's dancing around like it's an out of control fire hose. This is the PBR. I'm holding on for 8 seconds, motherfucker, okay? And he's dancing around. The entire time this is happening, Bob Saget is on the floor laughing. And then in a moment, I could not write, if you gave me 1,000 opportunities, Dave Coulier walks in the dressing room, sees me humping Stamos's leg, and without missing a beat, just goes, hey, Brad, cut it out. I'm like, get the fuck out of here! Montreal. My name is Brad Williams. Thank you, guys.
Nice, nice person, really funny. A really nice vibe of comedy. I like him. PBR, he said one time. PBR, physically based rendering. PBR. It is the PBR guide, professional bull riders. Ah, I understood, yes. I wanted to understand what is PBR, and right now I know what is it. Need to make more like reviews on this channel about things in America, like cultural things. Maybe about serials, about TV shows, what have I learned from TV shows. Need to learn all this stuff. Right now I learn like comedy helps me to learn it, and need to make my own like maybe review show of it, like to be more inside of this culture. Yes, thank you a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was really interesting to know this Brad Williams, and his accent is so understandable. May I ask you, where is he from? Brad Williams, need to Google. I think that he's not New Yorker, he's more... One moment. Brad Williams is an American stand-up comedian actor, California, okay. And he's 132 meters, and he's 36 years old right now, and this stand-up made maybe 2015 or ish. Okay, he looks kind of why does he have so big butt? And it is interesting because his body is not super big, but his butt is so big. If we look at this picture, look, I mean that this part near lower than lower back. Yes. And okay, thank you a lot for watching this video. It was interesting to learn new words like this cereal. I forgot what's name of it. And DRV and PBR. DVR and PBR. Nice. And Lucky Charms. Yes. And interesting, really. Have a wonderful day. Have a great moments in your life. I don't know how to say it correct. Have great moments or have a great moments. Please, if you know, let me know in the comment section, because it is so confusing me sometimes how to say it correct. I know that need to say have a great day, have a wonderful day, but how to say have nice moments? Need to say with article or without? Okay. Thank you a lot for your help, and see ya in the next time. Bye bye.